This episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence.
Like Genovia.
Yes.
A princess? Shut up!
The question is not do you want to be a princess, or do you want to be on camera, or do you want to speak in public? The question is, are you willing to do all those things that you don't want to do
in order to do the good that you do want to do?
And that is how you achieve self-actualization, that accountability, that accepting influence, that facing your fears, and stepping into your voice. That's how you become the best version of yourself. Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. Joining me, as always, is...
me.
Yep, that's him. We don't need to even know who he is. Let's just keep going. No, who are you?
I'm Alan Seawright. I'm a professional filmmaker who needs therapy.
All right, let's do this. Psychology of a Hero on The Princess Diaries.
Yeah, Princess Diaries.
Amelia Mignonette Thermopolis Renaldi, Princess of Genovia.
Or Mia, for short.
Shut up!
Okay.
We're going to talk about self-actualization.
Okay.
Which, according to Maslow, is the uppermost in the hierarchy of needs, is self-actualization.
Is it Maslow or Maslow?
I've heard it both ways.
I don't know, and I should know because it's my
field.
You
really should.
I really should.
Yeah.
I've read it a lot, but Okay. Whatever, it's fine.
Some guy, he's dead.
So self-actualization is defined as reaching your highest potential.
Mm-hmm.
So let's start with Mia's fears and insecurities, and then we'll go from there.
What's my point again?
You like our uniforms. They're equalizers.
Now we'll hear the rebuttal from Mia Thermopolis, who will present...
She looks more like Hermione than Hermione does.
Position.
True.
I think...
What a frizzball. Look at her hair.
Shh. Maddie Moore seems lovely in real life, but she plays bully so well.
Really well.
You see, casual.
Oh.
Are you okay? She's gonna barf.
Look out, she's gonna hurl.
ADR jokes.
Oh my gosh.
When you don't have a real joke and you think of something later.
So there's this girl in my class that I wanted to impress by showing her that even in second grade, I'm like, I'm not like other guys. I'm sensitive.
I'm not like other guys.
Oh, no.
So I stood up in music class and I don't think there was any reason for me. I'm just like, excuse me, I'd like to sing a song now. And my music teacher's like, okay. And I tried to sing Santa Fe from Newsies.
Santa Fe.
I got halfway through it and kids were laughing at me and teasing me and my knees were knocking together.
Uh-huh.
This is the saddest thing. I literally just stopped and said, I'm sorry. And then I just sat down.
Oh, no!
As the girl I liked was laughing at me, everyone was laughing at me.
Oh.
It's not quite throwing up in the hallway, but...
Jono.
I know.
I'm so sad for you and I so understand why those kids bullied you. Because I'm old and I have perspective. I can see both sides now.
It's dark. We're excited about a project we've been working on and we're ready to share with you. A new cinema therapy website, yo.
Yo. Mm-hmm. We used Squarespace, yo, to build our new yo site, yo.
Too much
yo?
That's okay. Their templates make it easy to start building a website, and we didn't have to build it from scratch.
There are so many templates to choose from. They fit a wide variety of styles, formats, and royalty.
It was really simple to change the branding, graphics, fonts, and colors to make it our own.
We were able to build a site that acts as a hub to link all of our work, like YouTube, Patreon, our merch and popcorn stores, social media links, the Royal Pear Jugglers website.
Okay, built-in tools like video blocks and extensions for all these platforms made it easy to do just that.
Squarespace also has a ton of other resources like Made with Squarespace.
Squarespace blog.
Help Center.
Forum and webinars.
That are so helpful for people starting out with Squarespace.
So if you're busy running a YouTube channel, or maybe a small country, and don't want to spend months building a website, all these resources make it quick and easy to build said website.
Check out squarespace.com for a free trial.
And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/cinematherapy to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.
We asked Squarespace if we could go /Genovia, and they said no.
But I am the master of my domain. So Mia is scared of speaking in public. She's scared of putting herself out there and having all eyes on her. It's not what she wants at all.
Right.
Let's see what else she doesn't want to do.
What about him? Edouard Christophe Philippe Gerard Renaldi was your father.
Yeah, sure. My father was the Prince of Genovia.
Uh-huh, you're joking.
Why would I joke about something like that?
No, because if he's really a prince, then I...
Exactly. You're not just Amelia Thermopolis. You are Amelia Mignonette Thermopolis Renaldi, Princess of Genovia.
Julie Andrews is our queen.
Me? A princess? Shut up!
I beg your pardon. Shut up.
Your Majesty, in America, it doesn't always mean be quiet. Here, it could mean...
This guy just, like, poked in to explain it.
Nevertheless, you are the princess. And I am Queen Clarice Renaldi.
Why on earth would you pick me to be your princess?
Since your father died, you are the natural heir.
Not actually how that works.
Yeah.
Royal by marriage. You are royal by blood. You can rule.
Rule? Oh, no. Oh, no. No, no, no. Now you have really got the wrong girl. I never lead anybody. Not at brownies, not at campfire girls. Queen Clarice, my expectation in life is to be invisible, and I'm good at it.
Amelia, I had other expectations also. In my wildest dreams, I never expected this to happen. But you are the legal heir, the only heir to the Genovian throne, and we will accept the challenge of helping you become the princess that you are. Oh, I can give you books. You will study languages, history, art, political science. I can teach you to walk, talk, sit, stand, eat, dress like a princess. Given time, I think you'll find the palace in Genovia a very pleasant place to live.
I want Julie Andrews to teach me to be a princess.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa, just rewind and freeze. I'm no princess. I am still waiting for normal body parts to arrive. I refuse to move to and rule a country. And do you want another reason? I don't want to be a princess.
Amelia.
Americans and their free will.
So disrespectful.
So two things. Anne Hathaway deserved to rocket to stardom after this movie.
Absolutely. This was her first film.
Yeah. Number two, there's a reason why we were silent through most of that scene. The writing is fine. It's just because Julie Andrews is speaking.
You cannot talk over Julie Andrews. If you do, you will be struck by lightning.
Mia, two things, is afraid of being in the limelight and speaking in public. And secondly, she says, I have one expectation out of life, which is to be invisible.
And I'm good at it.
She doesn't have any aspirations for herself. She doesn't have any ambitions. She just wants to kind of breeze through life, eke through life unnoticed. And now she has her grandmother, and to a certain extent her mother and other people saying, well, here's who we want you to be.
Mm.
And the thing about self-actualization is it's a process of discovering what you want. But she hasn't entertained what she wants.
Right.
And now others are telling her, and she says, okay, I'll give it a try. She has her She's All That / Pretty Woman style makeover. All sorts of stuff happen. There's a tabloid frenzy. She loses sight of who her friends really are. She gets swept up in others' expectations for her, and it just, like, implodes and blows up in her face. Those are two separate things, but I'm running with it.
It both implodes and explodes.
And she makes some choices that aren't true to who she is because she doesn't know who she is. But here's where we get to what self-actualization looks like. She can't self-actualize until she takes a hard look at who she is and what she wants. And the problem is, up until, like, late in the film, she's letting fear dictate her choices, not confidence and not desire. Fear of disappointing her grandmother, fear of disappointing the Genovians, fear of disappointing her friends. And then when she does go after something for herself, it goes terribly on the beach.
Yeah, because bullies, and also because her friend is terrible.
Yeah, yeah. She leaves her friend hanging, but then we get to this.
Is that cool?
Sure, let's talk. But about what? How you broke my brother's heart, or how you stuck me with Jeremiah during my cable show doing pick a card, pick a card, pick a card.
I'm sorry, okay? I forgot to call you and tell you that I couldn't make it.
I'm super triggered that this, like,
happy Houdini boy, you're making out with
annoying teen girl is a much better basketball player than me.
I had that same thought.
I don't want to talk about alliteration.
Well, you know what? I came up here to tell you that I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry I missed your cable show, and
I'm just really sorry. No, I can't believe that you hung me up after all I did for you. You know, I kept your royal secret. And do you know how hard it is to have a cable show and keep a secret?
You didn't keep it a secret from me, how jerky you thought my being a princess was. Well, congratulations, you got your wish. I'm not gonna be a princess.
You're not?
No.
I didn't want you to be a princess, but I do now because I'm a terrible friend. Ugh. Just, ugh. Sorry. I don't know why she's friends with this person who's very annoying and also better at basketball than me.
Because she's friends with her because of that. And she has terrible form, and yet she sinks every shot.
Every shot goes in. It makes me wonder, did they do 50 takes or is she just a prodigy? Like, I don't know.
I don't think her stinking baskets is essential to the scene.
It's not. I think it's just she's really good.
Yeah. But here Mia steps into accountability, apologizes, and takes ownership for her behavior. And that's the first step into self-actualization.
Sure.
You cannot reach your potential if you're not accountable for your mistakes. If you don't learn and grow, then you stop.
Right.
And there's no self-actualization. But the next step is to accept influence. We need to be able to learn from the people around us.
I didn't mean it. Just the green monster of jealousy came out because you were Miss Popular and I thought I was losing my best friend.
She's a terrible dribbler.
Yeah.
Sad and hurt. And I told you.
She's just Steph Curry from the line.
Good adjustment. But the truth is,
good ownership.
Being a princess is kind of a miracle. Whoa.
No. What miracle? It's a nightmare.
No. Think about it. I just found out that my cable show only reaches 12 people. Wanting to rock the world, but having zip power like me, now that's a nightmare. But you, I mean, wow. I mean, just...
Okay.
Isn't this the rooftop from Pursuit of Happiness?
It is. Same place.
Wow is having the power to affect change, make people listen. How many teenagers have that power? What more of a miracle do you want?
Well...
Pan over and Will Smith is crying.
To find a different miracle, not more, just different.
To be fair, you can do that in most places.
That's true. You can.
Tomorrow night is Genovian.
Will Smith is crying in a lot of places.
And to make up for my missing your cable show, I'm inviting you. I hope you'll forgive me. And I hope you come.
So something that Lily does for Mia right here is helps her see, okay, you don't like speaking in public, you don't like having the limelight on you, and you don't really want to be a princess. But think about this. You have the power and capacity to influence and help people on a large scale.
Yep.
And the question is not, do you want to be a princess, or do you want to be on camera, or do you want to speak in public? The question is, are you willing to do all those things that you don't want to do
in order to do the good that you do want to do?
The fact is, like, there is literally nothing you can do, no matter how much you love it, that doesn't have parts of it that you hate.
Right.
Right? The parts of it that... I love doing therapy. I hate writing case notes.
I love doing this show. I hate sitting next to Jono.
Oh my gosh!
He smells horrible.
That's not true! That
no,
is not
he actually
true.
Smells like sandalwood. He smells quite nice.
I have many faults, but hygiene is not one of them. Take good care of my smells.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Also, fun fact about that scene, that rooftop is across the street from the Oh Hi Mark rooftop.
From the room?
I did not hit her. I did not. Oh, hi, Mark.
Yeah, except they didn't actually film there.
They filmed on a green screen.
They filmed on a green screen and then went and shot plates, and then they later found out they could have just shot on that roof. But that's not how you do it in a real Hollywood movie.
But the plates are right there. And if you think about it, it's clearly
across the street from this rooftop.
And that neighborhood's like fine, but I don't know why.
Why is every movie there?
Yeah. The third step to self-actualization is to face your fear. And we're going to look at this in two parts.
It's locked. If you open the locket I gave you, it becomes the key.
Thank you for bringing it down here.
I... also came to apologize for the way I spoke to you about the beach incident.
That was a lot of cat.
Judgmental of me, I didn't pause.
And we've got the cat POV.
For no reason.
Gary Marshall, what is wrong with you?
I've been thinking about it a great deal, and the truth is...
And now we just crossed the line.
I think you'd make a very fine princess. You know, people think princesses are supposed to wear tiaras, marry the prince, always look pretty and live happily ever after. But it's so much more than that. It's a real job.
You are an extraordinary person, Grandma. But I don't think I meant to do this. I would be so afraid that I would disappoint the people of Genovia, and I couldn't bear to disappoint you again.
Well, as I said, I have faith in you.
Gary Marshall, an actor's director.
Not so much a camera director. What the hell is up with the cat? Why? We hold on the cat for so long, and then we cut to the cat's POV, looking down on these people while they're having an emotional conversation. There are other things you can do, Gary. I really feel bad calling out a guy who is dead, and who by all accounts was a delightful, wonderful human. He just sucked at placing cameras. I'm sorry. It drives me bananas. This whole movie makes me want to punch everything.
Again, he's great with actors. He gets charming performances.
Absolutely.
You watch Pretty Woman, Runaway Bride. He gets these great performances. But I didn't even notice that that was the cat's POV until you said it. And now I can't stop thinking about it.
Why the hell are we looking for the cat's eye view? What are we doing? Gary!
Gary!
Here is the freaking hardest part of self-actualization. Overcoming your fears about yourself.
Oh, is that why I'm not self-actualized?
Oh, gosh. I could help you with that, but I won't.
Okay. That's why I go to therapy.
Oh my gosh.
Also.
I'm in a salty mood today, folks. I don't know what's going on. I'm sorry. I apologize.
It's okay. It's fine. I'll be fine.
But Mia, originally she's like, I don't want to. I don't feel comfortable. I don't want to do it. Now she actually kind of wants to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But she's afraid that she's not going to measure up.
Right.
Right? She's gonna afraid that she's gonna let people down, her grandmother, the people of Genovia. She thinks the task is worthy, I'm not worthy. So how does she learn to overcome that?
It is a custom in my family to pass on a piece of wisdom when one reaches this age.
Letter from her late father.
You, as my father, passed it on to me. Amelia, courage is not the absence of fear, but rather the judgment that something else is more important than fear. The brave may not live forever, but the cautious do not live at all. From now on, you'll be traveling the road between who you think you are and who you can be. The key is to allow yourself.
Rene Auberjonois. That's where I recognize the voice.
Mm.
Star Trek. Huge nerd.
I loved your mother very much and still think of her often. Happy birthday, my Mia. All my love, your father.
So, very good book with an exceptional title is called Feel the Fear and Do It Anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And that is what courage is. It's not fearlessness. It's I'm scared to death.
And I'm going to do it anyway.
Yeah. And that gives her the nudge that she needs. And the fact is, that's true for all of us. The thing that we're scared to do, if we wait until the fear's gone...
You're going to be waiting a long-ass time.
Which brings us to voice your choice.
Okay.
Earlier this evening, I had every intention of giving up my claim to the throne. And my mother helped me by telling me that it was okay and by supporting me like she has for my entire life. But then I wondered how I'd feel after abdicating my role as Princess of Genovia. Would I feel relieved or would I feel sad?
Julianders is a queen.
I realized how many stupid times a day I use the word I. In fact, probably all I ever do is think about myself. And just how lame is that when there's like 7 billion other people out there on the planet? And when... sorry, I'm too fast. But then I thought, if I cared about the other 7 billion out there instead of just me, that's probably a much better use of my time. See, if I were Princess of Genovia, then my thoughts and the thoughts of people smarter than me would be much better heard. And just maybe those thoughts could be turned into actions. So this morning when I woke up, I was Mia Thermopolis. But now, I choose to be forevermore Amelia Mignonette Thermopolis Renaldi, Princess of Genovia.
So her giving the speech wearing a sopping wet hoodie, I know
that's kind of great.
It's kind of great. I think it's symbolizing she's being herself still.
Yes.
You know, like they dress her up as a princess a little bit later to do the photo ops and everything. But instead of running from this and throwing up, and instead of running from the responsibility, it's only when it becomes her choice. We poo-poo a lot the outside influence of others telling us what to do with our lives. Mm. But sometimes listening to those voices, as long as you're not letting them make the choice for you.
Yeah, no, other people are smart.
Sometimes. She accepted influence to make this choice, but it was still...
It was her choice.
And it's something that she wanted to do sincerely. Right. And that is how you achieve self-actualization, that accountability, that accepting influence, that facing your fears, and stepping into your voice, right? Okay. And having that voice. That's how you become the best version of yourself. And we see in the second film, which is mostly just a Hallmark movie fluff that has no point.
It has a point.
What's that point?
Chris Pine. Chris. Have you looked at Chris Pine?
I have. And
there's a lot of point to that movie. That's all I'm saying.
Whoa.
Above average.
The one thing we see in the second film is her following through with what she arrives at in this film, which is using her position to help people. There's a lovely scene in the parade with the children. It's great. That and Chris Pine's eyes are about the only reason to watch that.
So this is a movie. Gary Marshall put some cameras there, I guess.
So you've seen what it looks like from the cat's perspective. If you want to see our shoot from the perspective of Alan's dog, for all of your dumping on Gary Marshall, you sure hopped aboard the strap a camera to a pet and see what happens idea. That's on our Patreon. Check it out. So until next time.
If this were a hearse, there would be silence in the backseat.
Goodbye, trolley people.
And watch movies.
A special shout out to all of our patrons for helping to support this show, including
John Giam,
Melinda Layden,
Lizzie Giles,
Rose Lemon,
Robert.
It's like Robert. It's like Madonna.
Or Sting.
Or Prince. Patreon.com/cinematherapy. We're descending into madness. We'll see you later.
Robert.